हेलो स्टूडेंट, गुड मॉर्निंग, वेलकम इन 15th लेक्चर ऑफ लीनियर इक्वेशन इन वन वेरिएबल। नाउ अवर एक्सरसाइज नंबर 2.4 इज गोइंग ऑन एंड टुडे वी हैव टू सी क्वेश्चन नंबर 5। क्वेश्चन नंबर 5 इज द शोबोज मदर्स प्रेजेंट एज इज 6 टाइम्स शोबोज प्रेजेंट एज। First of all, we have to consider the Shobo's present age. Now, solution. Let Shobo's present age be X years. If we consider that Shobo's present age be X year, so his mother's age will be 6 times. Times means multiplication. So his mother's age will be 6x years. Therefore, his mother's age will be equal to 6x years. Okay? After that, next sentence. Shobo's present age. After that, next sentence is Shobo's age 5 years from now. According to question, see, this concept is very important for simplification. For the simplification, Shobo's age 5 years from now. Now, Shobo's age 5 years from now will be x plus 5 years. It will be 1/3, means 1/3. 1/3 of his mother's present age. And his mother's present age is the 6x. Now see the condition. Very easy to understand. Shobo's age 5 years from now will be x plus 5. Will be 1/3, means 1/3. 1/3 of his mother's present age. And his mother's present age is 6x. I hope you understand this condition. Now make a simplification. X plus 5 equals to 3 to the 6, so right hand side will be 2x. After that, transfer this x, 5 equal to 2x minus x, therefore 2x minus x means x equal to 5. Here we get the value of x. If we get the value of x, then we can find out their present ages. Therefore, Shobo's present age is equal to x years, and value of x is 5, so Shobo's present age will be 5 years. After that, we have to find out his mother's age. Now his mother's present age is 6x years. 6x, put the value of x, which is 5, 6 into 5, 30 years. So his mother's age, present age, will be 30 years, and Shobo's present age will be 5 years. In this question, you have to remember this condition. After 5 years, Shobo's age will be x plus 5, is 1/3 of his mother's present age. This is the main condition of this question. I hope you understand question number 5. Now we have to see question number 6. Now student, we have to see question number 6. Question number 6 is, there is a narrow rectangular plot reserved for a school in Mahuli village. The length and breadth of the plot are in the ratio 11:4. Length and breadth of the plots are in the ratio 11:4. First of all, we write down the length and breadth of that plot. Now, solution. Rate of fencing is rupees 100 per meter. So 100 multiplied by its perimeter. And how much cost village panchayat required for fencing? 75,000. Rupees 75,000. Now put the value of perimeter 100 multiplied by perimeter is 30x. Equals to 75,000. 100 into 30x, 3000x equal to 75,000. Transfer this 3000, x equal to 75,000 divided by 3000. 000, 000 cancel. X equal to 75 divided by 3, that is x equal to 25. Here we get the value of x. After getting the value of that variable, what we have to find? What are the dimensions of the plot? Dimension means length and breadth. Therefore, the length of plot, the length of plot will be 11x. If 11x, we are considering its length 11x, put the value of x, 11 multiplied by 25. Make a multiplication, 11 by 55, 25, 11 to the 22, 22 plus 5, 27. 275 meters will be the length of that plot. After that, we have to find out its breadth. The breadth of plot is b equals to how much it is given? We consider 4x meter. 4 multiplied by x. 4 multiplied by value of x is 25. So its breadth will be 4 into 25, 100 meter. Now the dimension, means its length and breadth. Its length is 275 meter and breadth is 100 meter. Here we complete our question number 6. In this question, the main condition is the rate of fencing is 100 rupees per meter multiplied by its perimeter, and the cost required for the village panchayat is 75,000. How we find out? The cost multiplied by perimeter equal to the total cost. I hope you understand today's question number 5th and 6th. In next lecture, we have to take question number 7. If you are in any difficulty, then always you can ask me.